The outlook wasn't brilliant for the Chicago 53 that day. The score stood 19-7 with but one quarter more to play. And when Robbie Gould unleashed a mighty kick that went awry, the fans at Soldier Field were certain this game was doomed to die. "They've won four straight," said one melancholy chap within the stands. And though their run was sure to end, this was not within the plans. A loss to Carolina, a team with just one win, and to do it on the home field was perhaps a mortal sin. But the defense forced Cam Newton to commit a three and out, and the offense, in their mind, held not one shred of doubt. They knew their strong-armed quarterback could lead them down the field, and Marshall, Forte, and Hester were the weapons he would wield. Then on second down and eight, Big J uncorked the ball, throwing a score to Kellen Davis to the wonderment of all. A charge of hope and optimism rippled through the crowd, for these Bears possess a defense of which the fans are proud. When Gold lined up to kick off again, the clock was under seven, and Bears fans remembered Arizona and a punt return from Devin. That play capped off a comeback, kept the season rolling strong. They made it to the Super Bowl before everything went wrong. But their thoughts were interrupted when Steve Smith slipped and fell, and Tim Jennings snatched the ball and ran like hell. And when the dust had lifted, the fans' heads, they were a-spinning. There was Jennings in the end zone, and by God, the Bears were winning. Now it was the defense's chance to make the Panthers fold, but they are led by Newton, who can make your blood run cold. The Bears' defense was strong and brave and gave their very best, but Newton, mighty Newton, simply put them to the test. He picked up 16 yards on a run on 3rd-and-1, and Carolina's field goal made Newton think that they had won. The Bears' D was exhausted. They'd given it their all. And now, to win, they'd have to trust the offense with the ball. The long-limbed Marshall was concerned. He said that he was shaken. But one look at Cutler's smile, and he knew he was mistaken. "The guys feel that vibe," said Marshall, "and they play off of it. The team has Cutler's back, 'cause they know that Jay won't quit." Sure enough, Cutler fired, hitting receivers far and near, and Carolina froze like when headlights hit a deer. The offense marched 55 yards, and with just 4 seconds more, Robbie Gould trotted out to change the final score. A 41-yard field goal is certainly no gimme, but Gould's been here before, and fans just thought, hey, no biggie. And now Manley snaps the ball, and Podlish makes the hold, and now the air is shattered by the right leg of Robbie Gould. Oh, somewhere in this favored land, the sun is shining bright. The band is playing somewhere, and somewhere hearts are light. And what happened in Chicago, where our colors never run? Gould hit his kick, of course, and the Bears are 6-1.